Yo, what's good, YouTube? It's YBC, and I'm back with a video. In this video, I'm going to be bringing to you guys a video where I'm going to be going on a shopping spree and spending 1.5 or close to 1.5 million MT on a brand new God Squad. So about 3 to 4 weeks ago, I went on a 1 million MT shopping spree where I got new players and such with 1 million MT. But now that there has been more content that released over the last few weeks and such, I'm going to be spending up to 1.5 million MT and forming a God Squad that's close to now 1.5 million MT. So quick, before we hop into the video and everything, if you guys are new, just make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. I try my best to upload 2K's content every single day. And also, if you guys can do me a favor and smash that like button. Let's try and smash the like goal of 200 likes on this video. So yeah, this is kind of something that I kind of want to do once a month where I go on shopping sprees and form new God Squads. This video is pretty much, you know, gonna update you guys on what squad I'm using, like every single video and such, my God Squad I use for Unlimited and stuff like that. So yeah, not only am I gonna be spending MT, but also I'm gonna be updating you guys on the God Squads that I do have. Usually once a month is when I'll start. I'll probably just start uploading this series once a month because I'm having a good time with it so far. I'm having some fun recording these videos. So moving right along, let's dive straight into enough of the intro. Let's get into the shopping spree and how much MT this new God Squad costs. So at the point guard position right here, we have this pink diamond Magic Johnson. Now after the market crash, he's going for 150,000 MT. So with that being said, it was only right for me to get him. In my opinion, he is the best point guard in the game. You can make a case and say Opal, Chris Paul is the best point guard, but Magic Johnson has the height. All you have to do is back down that Chris Paul and you're going to score on him every single time. But yeah, Magic Johnson, in my opinion, is the best point guard in the game. And he cost me 150,000 MT, who is going to be my starting point guard. At the starting shooting guard position, we have the Diamond Scottie Pippen. This Scottie Pippen is just simply a god on both sides of the court. The best two-way player in the game. The best defender, you know what I'm saying? The best two-way type of card in the game. His defense is absolutely incredible, arguably the best defender in the game. A Hall of Fame defensive stopper just makes him overpowered. And offensively as well, he has a really nice driving dunk and three ball at 91 open three and 90 driving dunk. He can also speed boost. So for 100,000 MT as a two-way player, Scottie Pippen is great. Who's going to be my starting shooting guard position? So moving on to the small forward position right here, we have this Diamond Danny Granger. Now this Diamond Danny Granger is arguably the best card in the game. You know, you can make a case and say that he is. And with that being said, he is going for almost 400,000 MT. Like, we take a look at this card right here, this Danny Granger. I mean, he's just going for so much. He is going for 374,000 MT with 1 hour and 13 minutes remaining. So with that being said, he can honestly creep up to 500,000 MT. But for this video, I'm only going to put his price tag at 400,000 MT. Some people say this man is overrated. I don't think he is. You know, he gets speed boost, that base 11 jump shot, he's shooting over everybody. 94-3, but with the coach, you can put that at 99. 80 driving dunk, but really it feels like he has a 99 driving dunk. Like, he gets speed boost. Some people say this card's overrated. I don't think he is. For 400,000 MT, he is the most expensive card in the game, you know, but thankfully I got this card for less than 400,000 MT, but still, with that being said, we are just going to value him at 400,000 MT because that is what his price is at. But yeah, moving right along to the power forward position, we did screw up this pink diamond Blake Griffin for only 140,000 MT. Now, because of the 20th anniversary lock code, there was a huge market crash on the 20th anniversary pink diamonds. I took advantage of that and bought this pink diamond Blake Griffin for only 140,000 MT. This card is a walking bucket. His slashing takes over makes him a god. Like, he's a great rebounder as well. You can easily put him at the center position, but I'm gonna run him at the power forward position just for, you know, I like big bodies out there. I like having height because a lot of people do run height unlimited. So yeah, we're gonna run him at the power forward position, and then that's gonna lead us into our center position. Who are going to start? Diamond Marc Gasol. Now this Diamond Marc Gasol right here is pushing 50,000 MT. He kind of has a beer belly in his card art, but that's besides the point. Still, 95 overall center with great shooting badges, 7'1" and 92 open shot three. You can't beat that as a stretch big, you know. Stretch big who has amazing rebounding and three. It's hard to beat that, so he's going to be at my starting center position. So now if we add up the starting five, we have Pink Diamond Magic, who is now 150,000 MT. Diamond Scottie Pippen, who is 100,000 MT, that's 250,000. Danny Granger, who was pushing 400,000 MT, that is 650,000. Blake Griffin, I got for 140. We're gonna run that up to 150. That is 800,000 for these four players. And Diamond Marc Gasol, who is another 50,000 MT. With that being said, we're gonna push this squad to give or take, roughly the starting five is gonna be close to 900,000 MT. I say give or take because some of these cards are worth more than what I've said, and some of them are worth less, so we're just gonna give or take and round up to 900,000 MD. Now moving right along to the first position off the bench is this pink diamond Giannis. Now, is he going to be playing my point guard? No, but he is the highest overall off the bench, so we're going to start with him first. And he's worth 300,000 MT now after the market crash. After the market crash, this Ping Damianis went from 500,000 MT to 300,000 MT. So we're going to value him at 300,000 in this video because that's how much he's going for. And so, yeah, I did buy him for a little bit more than that, but still, we're talking about the base prices right now, how much they're going for at the time I'm recording this video. This Giannis goes for 300,000 MT. I did buy this Ping Damianis for 340,000 MT. I mean, you can make a case and say he is the best player in the game, you know. All these guys on my team are really, really good at their positions, you know. One of the best, if not the best at their position. Same thing with Giannis, you know, small forward, probably the best small forward in the game. Now, moving right along, off the bench, we have the brother of Marc Gasol, Diamond Pau Gasol. The main reason why I have him is because he's a really good all-around big man. I mean, he's 3 in mid-range, 96 mid-range, 83 open 3, 90 standing dunk, you know, pretty good rebounding, really good badges. Like, his card's a really good all-around center, you know, and especially because he has that 3 ball is why I really like him as well. So, yeah, this Diamond Pau Gasol is going to be off the bench, and I did buy him for 60,000 MT. On to the next position off the bench, and how could this be a video without this Hedo Turkoglu? This man right here is probably the most underrated card in the game. If you don't have yourselves the Hedo Turkoglu, what are you guys doing? Like, this man Hedo is so good. You can honestly, like, say he's a pink diamond in an amethyst form. His release just makes him OP. I mean, if it wasn't for his release, he probably wouldn't be as good. But his base 11 release, same thing. If you guys are wondering what the base 11 release is, it's the same release like Danny Granger has, same release as AK, same release as Bob Pettit, same release as Tom Guzmagata. This amethyst Hedo Turkoglu has, which makes him, you know, a god in this game. Like, you can literally just shoot over people. He's 6'10" and has that release. So we did buy him for 10,000 MT, and he is on the squad. On to the next player off the bench is its amethyst Draymond Green. Now, off the bench, we do have some really good players like Pau Gasol, Hedo Turkoglu, and Giannis. But those three don't really play the best defense, which is why we need a defensive anchor in this Draymond Green, who I did buy for 7,000 MT. This Draymond Green has been on my team for a while. As you guys see, we played 22 games with him. But yeah, we did buy him for like 6 to 7,000 MT, like 4 or 5, like when he first came out, to be honest. I don't think I've sold him back. I love this card. He's a great defensive anchor. He can guard all 5 positions. So yeah, with that being said, 7,000 MT is a must cop for this Draymond Green. And we do have him on the squad. Now, moving on to the last position off the bench, we have bought ourselves an amethyst Dwayne Wade. Now, he's going to be running my point guard off the bench. He's a great player, just an all-around walking bucket. He can play make, he can shoot, and this Wade actually can shoot. He does have an 80 open 3, but I do have some coaches which are going to up it. But yeah, with that being said, great slasher at 95 driving dunk, 86 ball control. I feel like he's a solid point guard because he can also play defense. He's athletic, you know. I feel like he's going to be the solid point guard off the bench. I know he's a shooting guard. I am running about the point guard, but he is 6'4". So, I mean, there are like tons of 6'3 and 6'4". I mean, Lonzo's 6'6". There's a lot of taller point guards. It's not like I'm running Granger at the point or Blake Griffin at the point. I'm going to be running this Dwayne Wade at the point guard position. I think that that's a good fit for him. I do think that that is a good fit off the bench, but at the same time, I was thinking about selling him back. The reason why I bring up selling back Wade is because I was thinking about selling him and getting Diamond Stephen Curry. I mean, I do have the MT. As you guys see, we have 75,000. I can sell this Wade for 30. But, you know, the reason why I bring that up is because off the bench, we don't have the best spacing. I mean, Wade has 80 open 3. Draymond has, I believe, 88, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, 86 open 3. Hedo Turkoglu has a 90. Now, if I have Diamond Stephen Curry with, like, close to 99 open 3, that would create so much more spacing for this bench. I'm thinking about getting Diamond Stephen Curry and selling back this Wade. But yeah, ultimately, I want to hear your guys' opinions and hear what you guys have to say. Should I sell back this Wade and get Curry? Because I think I need the spacing. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Here's the squad, as the starting five is close to 900,000 MT. And the bench is Giannis, who is 340,000. Pau Gasol, who is close to 60, that's 400,000. Hedo Turkoglu, who is about 5. Draymond Green. And off the bench, we have Giannis, who's 300,000 MT. This Diamond Pau Gasol is close to 60,000 MT. Amethyst Hedo Turkoglu is like 10,000 MT. The Draymond Green is like 7,000 MT. And this Amethyst Dwayne Wade I caught for 23,000. All in all, this bench costs close to 450,000 MT. So if we combine the starters, who is 900,000, plus the bench, who is close to 450,000 MT, give or take, this squad is close to 1.35 million MT. Now, the reason why I rounded up to 1.5 million MT in my title is because, as you guys see in the top right, we have 75,000 MT. So, give or take, you know, all in all, this squad's going to be costing close to 1.5 million MT if I spend an MT in my top right for Curry, which I probably am. But yeah, that's about it. Let me know in the comments below if you guys need any lineup suggestions. I do read all the comments, trust me, and I try my best to respond to everything. So if you guys need some lineup suggestions, leave a comment below and I will try my best. No, I won't try my best. I will respond to that comment. If you guys need any lineup suggestions anytime, drop a comment below and I will respond to it. And if you guys did enjoy, let me know, please, because I do want to kind of make this a series. But if you guys aren't really feeling it, just let me know and I won't upload it. But yeah, I did enjoy recording this video, and I do like recording these shopping sprees. I like going on shopping sprees. You don't really see much of those on YouTube. So if you guys do enjoy it, just let me know your honest thoughts and opinions on this new series. That's about it. That pretty much sums up the video. Here is the updated God Squad. All around it is great, and I'm having a lot of fun using it. So yeah, that being said, thank you guys for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one. It's YBC, and I'm out. Peace.